On 28, Agnes's temperature at 10 a.m. was, let's say, 37.7. So we come to 10 a.m., we trace it down, we look for 37, this is 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, then you plot it here. It's as simple as that. You can also cross it like this. It's also accepted. But I prefer the plotting, the dots. So you plot it like this. That's it. And after plotting, if it's the first day on the chart, then you use your straight edge to draw a line downwards. Some people use this as a landmark to make an angle, but the line should just be slanted downwards. It shouldn't be straight like this. The line should not be straight like this. No. And it should not go up like this. No. It should always go down. So, after plotting my 37.7 degrees Celsius, then I'll draw a straight line like this. If it is the first day of patient on the ward, you write on admission here, OA, indicating on admission. So that is the patient's first temperature that was checked on admission. In other instances, if this sheet is a second sheet, maybe the patient has finished 1 week and we have put another sheet on it, then this cannot be on admission. This is a continuation from a previous sheet. So you write this to tell anybody reading the chart that this is a continuation from another chart. Good. So now we have the 37.7. Then 2 p.m., we check temperature again and it is 37.9. So we come and count. This is 37.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9. This is 2 p.m. Then you dot it. Then you use your straight edge. If 6 p.m., it goes to 37.4. You plot it, 37.4. You plot it here. Use your straight edge. Always use the straight edge to do your lines. Some people will use freehand. No matter how accurate you are, your freehand can't be as straight as a straight edge. And some people also chart in a worm-like manner, which is also very wrong. So you keep charting. 10 p.m., patient's temperature went a little up. This is 37.7 again. Then you do it. If it moves into the next day, let's say if you check at 2 a.m., then the temperature has gone, let's say 36.9, because it's in the morning, at 2 a.m., then you chart and you draw your line. So you always check vital signs with a ruler. You have to go with a ruler. And let's take it that at 6 a.m., patient temperature rose to 39.5. Remember, you have to trace the time down and come and meet it with the temperature before you can chart. And sometimes it's difficult because when you are tracing down like this, you will miss. And instead of 10 a.m., you go and chart at 2 p.m. So if you have your paper in front of you, the paper is smaller, A4 sheet, than this board. You just use the ruler to trace the time. With that, there's no way you're going to miss into another time. Another way too is that you can count. If it is 10 a.m., it means it is 3 spaces from the left. 1, 2, 3. So when I'm coming to chart here, I just count 3 spaces. 1, 2, 3. Then I'm at 10 a.m. So that you don't miss. When you trace it down with your eye or your hand, it's easier to miss, which is not pardonable because this is healthcare. When you miss or your mistakes can lead somebody into wrong diagnosis and wrong medication and then other things that we don't want to happen. So let's say at 6 a.m., patient's temperature was 39.5. So this is 6 a.m. here. And this is 39. So this is 39.5. Which signifies patient is pyretic. So we need to do something. As a nurse, when temperature is too high, you have to intervene. We are not just interested in knowing the state of the temperature. We want to know if it is high so that we can bring it down. That's the most important thing. So when the temperature is 39.5, you have to bring it down by sponging the patient or giving medication or doing both. Usually we use tepid sponging. When you use tepid sponging, we expect temperature to drop by 1 degree Celsius. So after sponging 39.5, we expect it to drop to 38.5. So within that same time, 6 a.m., you sponge patients and it has dropped to 38.5. So you use a red pen to draw broken lines to where the temperature has dropped to. When anybody picks the chart, the person knows that, the temperature was 39.5 and the nurse intervened and it dropped to this. When the next person comes to check temperature at 10 a.m. and now it is, say, 38.7 here. This person will join it from here, not from here. Don't forget. Well, this is the temperature, but it dropped to this after intervention. But we won't chart from the aftermath of the intervention. We chart from the actual temperature before the intervention. So we draw it here. Then the charting continues. Maybe the next comes to this because interventions are being made and then it has started dropping. So we keep charting. This is how you chart the temperature. You keep charting till the sheet is full for the week, then you change the sheet. And we don't chart temperature alone. Vital signs is temperature, pulse, respiration. So in the next video, you find how to chart the pulse and alongside the temperature. The same time you are checking temperature, you are checking pulse.